Hello, Komeji29 here.
The Gaming Angel.
We're going to be watching the June 2024 Nintendo Direct. We've been waiting for this all day. So we're just going to get started on it.
No speculation. It's a good, other than, like, I think Pokemon and Epic Mickey and Luigi's Mansion, I really can't think of anything where it's pretty much all unknown, and that's what's so exciting.
Yeah.
Honey, so you've got a big storm
here
coming.
Here we go. Okay. Ooh, Mario.
Something Mario.
Luigi.
Oh, look at that art style.
Luigi. Wait, that art style reminds
me of the Mario and Luigi
RPGs.
Is it a new Mario and Luigi game?
Or a remake? One?
Oh, yeah, because didn't they do all their talking like that?
Yes. And it's that art style. It's literally like the art style like you see in the official art. It's like replicating all that.
Mario and Luigi!
Oh my gosh! Back from the dead!
We thought you were dead. Our death was greatly exaggerated.
This is like the golden renaissance of Mario RPGs. We had Super Mario RPG, Thousand Year Door remake. And now this!
It's cool seeing that art style in 3D.
Yeah. Looks, they replicated like the, all the little art that, all the drawn art like really well.
Yeah. Okay, so I see we have extension cords as villains.
Oh my goodness, this is so hype!
Everyone is just like, Mario Luigi is dead. Be like,
well, nope. Everyone was like, they've got to be, because they've been putting out surveys, like saying, like, do you want more Mario RPG games? So everyone was like, Mario Luigi? Mario
and Luigi?
Mario and Luigi?
And not just that, a full-blown 3D version.
This is a new game. This is a brand new game.
Yeah, because it's not even just like, a remaster of the older games. No. Mario & Luigi, Brothership!
Yes, Full Metal Alchemist, goodness, Brothership.
Mario & Luigi.
November 7th this year!
Hello, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi.
Well, they sure...
What a way to start!
They've been holding off on games and waiting to announce them.
This is
almost 9 years.
Yo.
The fact that they kept this under lock and key.
Yeah.
That is impressive.
Please look forward to
what a strong start.
Yeah.
Across mysterious islands, as well as.
Oh man, I definitely day one. I'm getting this.
Okay, let's see the first batch of headlines.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bring the championship.
The NES championship. Yeah. Okay.
The thrill of the Nintendo World Championship.
Yeah, this was something that they announced a little while back.
Yeah.
Take on over 100.
Yeah, because I remember they had these previous people who did the championships back in like the 90s come back to advertise it, which is a cool.
That's really cool.
Familiarize yourself with each challenge and perfect your time.
So like a whole speedrunning, basically.
Yeah, it's a bunch of like little micro. It's almost like WarioWare, but like more expanded, obviously.
Yeah.
But it's like micro little challenges.
Yeah, for this is a cool idea for especially people that really love to do speedrunning.
Yeah.
Check out classified information for handy.
Oh, I like the style. This is like the old
yeah,
guys.
Like the little manuals. That's cool.
Where you'll race against ghost data of players worldwide.
Oh, that's cool.
Half of the players will be eliminated. You've only got one shot to survive. Will you be the last one standing? Nintendo World Championships.
It's just silly. It's very Nintendo, but it's such a fun idea.
It is a really cool concept. I like it.
The digital version are available now on Nintendo eShop. A deluxe set containing a physical version of the game and other bonus items is also available.
I like the golden NES card.
Yeah, the NES cartridge.
The final battle of fairy tale is about to begin.
Anomaly Janie, I hope your ears are perked up. Your fairy tale.
Yeah.
Relive the climactic Alvarez Empire arc from the hit anime Fairy Tail.
Oh, so the final arc of the manga, I guess? In video game form, that's interesting.
Yeah.
I haven't read Fairy Tail, but I think that's the final arc of the manga. Yeah.
Well, they said the final battle, so I presume.
Real-time battles and unleash powerful attacks that fuse different.
Looks really. Oh. The art style they've captured perfectly.
Yeah.
Work together with your teammates to take down powerful enemies. Fairy Tail 2.
All right.
Launches
Fairy Tail
Koei Tecmo.
2. Of course. It's like an anime game? Of course!
Neat.
On a multi-dimensional journey.
Near?
No,
Fantasy series created.
Yeah, this is that mobile game.
Oh, yeah, the Hirohiko Sakaguchi.
Yeah, the Fantasian. I can't talk. Work's been long today.
I saw a white-haired character and I was like, Near?
Yeah, mobile game. They've been freeing a lot of mobile games, it seems. Look. There's a couple more I want you to free, like Castlevania, Grimoire of Souls, and Sonic Dream Team. Please!
Adjust a skill's trajectory to target multiple enemies at once.
Interesting.
You can also send enemies you've been.
Yeah, I know, because sometimes I see, like, on a Nintendo eShop, they'd be like, there's a game, and I'm like, that looks interesting. I looked it up, and it was a mobile game that they took out all, like, the microtransactions, and then they just reworked it.
Oh, so they fixed it.
They made it an actual game. No, it's like, there's a lot of neat stuff. Like, Nier was it Reincarnation, I think, was their mobile game that got shut down? And it has apparently a lot of significant actual canon lore in it. Everyone's like, put it on consoles, for Pete's sake!
This is why I really hope they, like, at some point remake some of the other mobile games for Kingdom Hearts, like they did for Coded.
Yeah.
Oh! They're up.
Yeah.
An update, okay.
Switch sports game. Dribble. Pass.
I like how instead of red versus blue, it's blue versus pink.
In 2-on-2 matches using motion controls.
The legacy of Splatoon.
Three-point challenge solo.
Well, I was thinking of red versus blue quotes in my head right now.
Up to four players can also compete in five.
It's not pink, it's a lightish red.
Besides local play, you can team up with
my name is Michael J. Caboose.
And I hate babies. So when are we going to get Mario Hoops 3-on-3 2?
Yes. It's what this has all been building up to.
Yeah.
Where's DS?
Looks interesting.
Yeah. I dig the art style already.
It's got a drawn art style.
Yeah. Like the hard, like, shadows are like all sketch lines.
Yeah.
What are you? I like your design. What are you? Ooh. What is this music? Let me turn this up. Ooh, a Metroidvania. What is this?
Oh. The music kind of makes me think of the Nier soundtrack.
It kind of reminds me of Nier a little bit in the soundtrack, but this gameplay. This art style. What are
little Doc Ock quack.
That's so cool. I dig this.
Mio, Memories in Orbit.
I want that.
Okay, cool.
I want it.
You made a very good first impression.
Classics.
Sold.
Leave it to a new update for.
I want to buy that Mio game.
Detective is solving a mystery.
New update.
With only Mickey and friends.
Interesting.
They said cartoon classics, which implies more than one game.
Yeah.
Instant evidence scattered throughout.
I wouldn't have expected them to give an update to this game.
It said also free update too, isn't it?
Yeah.
Start sleuthing because this free update launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
Oh, hello Kitty!
Adventures await.
So cute!
That game will do 10 million.
Customize your character.
Yes!
Fashion!
Fashion and the cute little creatives give me!
To
I'm a girl, I can't help it.
To solve mysteries and restore Friendship Island when Hello Kitty Island Adventure.
Oh, it's diabetes, I want it.
The Nintendo Switch system next year.
They're so cute.
That's going to remain in the top 10.
Oh!
Looney in this.
Oh, I was thinking like a Space Jam game for a second there.
Play is Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck, Porky Pig, and more.
Well, it's almost like Warner Brothers suddenly remembers they have Looney Tunes.
Yeah.
Hey, Warner Brothers. There's maybe a movie you should release.
Yeah.
Just so you know. I paid money for this, I'd also pay money for that, just so you know. I've always liked the Looney Tunes.
Everyone loves the Looney Tunes.
That's all, folks. Let's see if you'll be a game on. Emergency meeting.
You guys leaked the date. Sus. As soon as they said that they have an update coming up on the 18th, everyone's like, oh, okay, that's when the Nintendo Direct is. People are like, oh, we don't know. And then soon enough, when it was like 18th, and people were like, oh my gosh, Among Us, you did leak it.
Nintendo execs are like, emergency meeting.
A monster army is at your command.
Fairy tale again or something?
This is Felicida, a realm of monsters. Those
who command and
race that looks like a similar style
and play a vital role in the land's civilization. 10 a farm.
Okay, I was going to say, I was wondering, did Mashima do the art design?
He did do the art.
Okay, I was like, that makes so much sense because the characters, they look like straight out of fairy tale.
Against the Magus's army. Yeah.
Or Rave Master.
Or Rave Master.
Then cultivate. And
or Eden Zero.
Make your buddies come to life.
I'm getting Monster Rancher vibes from this.
They can then be trained for battle.
Monster Rancher finally reborn.
That's fairy tale.
Yes.
Commands to your monsters. And
that's a franchise that should come back.
In action-packed combat.
It kind of reminds me of like Pikmin, but with like RPG stuff.
Merge all of the battle buddies in your party to call forth a giant fusion summon and wreak havoc on your foes.
Great, oh, nice red dragon.
Join the rebellion to stop the Magus in Farmagia.
All right, another
thing.
A magic farm game. Okay, with creature catching. I dig it. I'll get it.
New Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong.
Is it going to be another Donkey Kong Country game?
This looks like...
Donkey Kong Country Returns, originally released...
Oh!
The Wii!
Yeah!
They're remastering
the Wii! I was wondering why this hadn't come out!
The tribe has hypnotized the local wildlife and...
Oh my goodness!
Precious banana...
It's finally free from the Wii!
Yes!
It looks
I'm getting this, yes. More Donkey Kong Country in my life is always welcome.
Yeah.
Roll on through. Each level is filled with hijinks, but they're no match for these tough bananas. From manic minecarts.
Oh my goodness. This is awesome.
Yeah.
This is a really good direct so far.
Yeah. I wonder how long this has been done and they were just waiting to like announce it.
Yeah.
Transportation methods available.
They've been just like sitting on good
stuff. Pass a Joy-Con controller to a buddy for two-player local co-op.
Oh, I remember those stages back when it first came out and everyone was like, this is so freaking cool.
It is.
Levels from the Nintendo 3DS version.
Oh! I forgot they made that version.
Donkey Kong Country.
Then we have the definitive version.
So Peak is what I'm hearing.
Yes.
Finally, Kino's back on the menu, boys.
So can we get a Donkey Kong Country's Return 3?
Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong's Jungle Escapades returns in HD. Plenty of wild actions and antics are in store with these Kongs. Next, please take a look at this.
Yes.
I am taking a look.
I will love to take a look.
I'm looking.
The time is nigh. What is this? I didn't want to get my hopes up because that character design reminded me of Hilda.
I was going to say, it reminded me of Hilda in Link Between...
Dragon Quest 3? I heard people saying that they might discuss Dragon Quest 3. Everyone speculated that, remake.
Yeah, they're talking about it going to be in like the 2D HD look, too.
Oh my gosh!
Dragon Quest 3 HD 2D remake! They could probably come up with a more creative title.
You know what? Like, this is the same like studio that gave us Triangle Strategy.
And Octo Fast Traveler.
I think we'll take it.
Now, season.
Oh, this looks so good. I am so getting this. I've only played Dragon Quest XI, but like I want to play more of them. I'm definitely getting this one. This looks fantastic. Oh my goodness, this looks good.
So good.
So good.
Forge your own path.
This direct is really good.
The legacy begins.
So this is the game how you remembered it being when you were a kid.
I salute you.
Dragon Quest III HD 2D Remake.
We are reaching inconceivable levels of we are so back.
We are so unbelievably back. Oh man. Whew. How do you feel nostalgic for a game you've never played?
Yeah.
This and music makes me feel nostalgic.
Are they going to be like, here are some other games that we did remakes of too? Oh!
What?
I was half joking. Ooh. Oh! So I was actually right. I was like, here are the other ones that we made.
Okay. I'll buy all three. Holy cow, that's awesome!
Dragon Quest III の映像。
Yes! Yes, I did!
予約発売日を発表できて、とても嬉しく思います。そして、
ジョン・シ
ュレッカー。Cheers to that, bro!
HD 通じで呼び入れることが決定しました。時系列としては、3が物語に始め
たの
に、3が。Oh, so it's Devil May Cry! They followed the Devil May Cry rules 3, then 1 and 2. Thank you, sir!
Thank you, Mr. Hori. We hope you're excited to play the
entire
trilogy, now in HD 2D.
That looks so good!
Let's continue with more headlines.
Wow, this has been banger after banger.
Well, they can't all be bangers.
Maybe I spoke too soon.
No offense if you like Funko Pops. I think they're creepy looking.
Great Scott. Is that Marty McFly? The world of Funko is coming.
I will say it's interesting that they're making a video game based on Funko Pops.
Yeah. It's like you can literally just put anything.
Locations based on over 20 iconic movies, TV shows, and more. Use special skills and crafted gadgets.
Shaun of the Dead?
They have Funkos for everything.
Unique puzzles, hidden areas, and
that's Scott Pilgrim.
Yep, there's Scott Pilgrim. I saw Ramona earlier.
And Cylons from Battlestar Galactica!
I told you there's like Funkos for everything.
There are Funkos for everything.
The universe. Funko Fusion pops
up. If you like Funkos, there you go.
I mean, it's certainly an interesting concept. You could have literally anything.
So basically, Funko Fortnite?
Yeah, basically.
Silly and strategic games.
Oh, wait a minute. Spooky? Yeah, I thought so. I was like, Luigi's Mansion. Definitely getting this.
Yes.
Hello. I love Luigi's Mansion.
Yeah.
And so many people have not actually played the 3DS version.
And other supernatural shenanigans. Luigi's Mansion 2 HD.
It looks so good.
Everyone's like, I wish they like did a little bit more. I'm like, I don't care, honestly. I just want the game as long as it plays good.
Quirky little Dempa man. Find him, catch him, and lead him on a joyful RPG.
Okay.
All right.
Explore dungeons and battle monsters.
This certainly is a goofy looking game.
Yeah.
Decorate your island however you like.
It is the game of all time.
It is. Animal Crossing Move Over.
Co-op can team up to catch special Dempa Man. The new Dempa Man is free to play and launches as a timed exclusive on Nintendo Switch July 22nd.
All right.
Let's be real. PlayStation and Xbox fans aren't going to be clearing out that game.
They're crying. They don't get that game.
Yeah.
Wait, Metal Slug?
Oh, wow.
Take control of your forces and pulverize enemy strongholds. Choose from over 300 units with different abilities.
Okay!
Hold out your decks.
This actually looks really cool.
Tussles.
So it's just like every single character that ever existed?
battle rivals around the world. This looks cool. And insane. Oh, wow, shadow dropping. All right, okay.
Okay.
Embark on an expedition of the damned in this eagerly awaited sequel to
Darkest
the Gothic
Dungeon.
RPG.
I didn't know about Darkest Dungeon 1, but
I didn't
that's
either.
Cool.
I kind of really dig this art style.
Yeah.
Fight off nightmarish fiends in turn-based combat. And upgrade your abilities after each deadly run.
Kind of like feels almost cartoon slash comic bookish,
yeah.
Like with those hard lines.
Yeah.
Pre-orders begin.
Things definitely
today
more comic book in my eyes.
Yeah.
I really dig that art style.
More
oh,
titles.
Hello.
No.
Lock in.
Yeah.
What are we getting? Oh my god.
Oh.
Do you want A Link to the Past again? You get it twice on the Nintendo eShop. But we get four swords, so I'll take it.
This is the version of Link to the Past that I originally played as a kid.
Yeah, I played the SNES.
Zero Mission.
Oh my gosh, Zero Mission!
Zero Mission.
Oh, yes, I'm so there.
Plus, coming to the new Nintendo 64.
Mature.
Switch Online. Mature.
Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark.
Turok's.
Turok's great too.
Dangerous Lost Land to stop the campaigners nefarious.
That's actually awesome.
In Turok, Dinosaur Hunter.
Yes, I'll take that.
Still a classic.
And
Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark. Yes!
Alien conspiracy.
It's back!
We are so back!
Oh my gosh.
Yes!
For Nintendo Switch Online Plus expansion pack.
Yes! Whenever we got all the other Rare Art games last time, I was like, Perfect Dark. Oh, and so I was like, this time, please, please, yes!
Set sail to save the day.
Oh. You could have ended right there, and I still would have been happy. This
yeah
direct is fantastic.
We have already gotten plenty of great stuff.
Join her on a journey to save her friend Ash.
I mean, I don't even know how long we've been watching. They've just been like, here's a game, here's a game,
yeah,
here's a game, here's a game.
The Phantom Brave series.
This looks cute.
Yeah. She is scientifically designed to be as cute as possible.
Yes, so they were like cooking in the lab and pouring all the formulas for as cute as possible.
In various ways.
Finally, perfect moe.
Combine phantoms with certain objects to maneuver them. Combine with a cannon to attack a large area.
So it looks kind of.
Oh, it's a tactics.
Yeah,
yeah,
tactical RPG is what it looks like.
Or combined with Morona herself for show-stopping abilities that can turn the tide of battle.
Oh, look, we made her cuter.
Yeah.
The Lost Hero launches on Nintendo Switch next year.
Okay. I might want to check that out. It looks fun.
This one's for a ride.
What? Oh, my gosh!
Oh!
No! 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 No way! X-Men versus Street Fighter?
Versus Street Fighter.
And so it was a collection.
So
Arcade of Marvels and Marvel 2! Marvel! Punisher!
Punisher? Oh my gosh!
And more.
Marvel Studios versus Street Fighter!
Hit up training mode to polish your fighting skills and combos.
Oh my gosh.
That's cool!
Okay, you can end right here and it would still be the perfect direct. Oh my gosh!
That's the first game to sell more billion copies.
Yes, it will sell more billion.
Crossover to the museum to.
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
And the music.
Versus Capcom Fighting Collection.
That is awesome. Oh my goodness! I'm so getting that. It is so hype. Oh, Mario Party.
A bigger, bolder Mario Party.
The latest game.
Switch is gonna have three Mario Parties. Nice.
On an enormous island resort.
Four. I only own two.
I haven't kept track.
I own Super Paper Mario and
Super Mario Party
or Super Super Paper Mario. I wish.
Super Paper Mario Party.
Super. Yeah, that. Do it. I own. I've been playing Thousand Doors, so Paper Mario's on the brain.
Use in-game coins to get a star.
I own Super Mario Party.
ride around and stay on track at Golem Raceway. With the new Turbo Dice item, you can move up to 40 spaces with a lucky roll.
And then the other one, suddenly the other Mario Party, the one on the Switch, I liked it a lot better, but suddenly its name flew out of my head. But that one I had a lot of fun with my siblings. The only thing was I felt like it needed more boards, but if this has got a lot more boards, then... The best ones! The ones me and my siblings play the most! Well, except it needs three. If you have three, then you're a hit peak. Because Mario 1 through 3, we played the crap ton out of that one. Oh my goodness, me and my siblings, it is on.
It's on like Donkey Kong.
It is on like Donkey Kong.
There's a wide variety to enjoy. Also,
how many characters is that?
Can go head to head.
Holy cow!
20 players.
Compete against your rivals.
I am so there. Place. I can't wait to like
try your best.
Siblings. You know what this means, right?
Online matches.
You know what this means, right? It is so on!
The biggest Mario Party yet will soon be underway. When the Super Mario Party...
Let's go, siblings! I'm gonna get you!
October 17th. That was the latest installment in the Mario Party series.
Every Christmas, that's a family tradition. We all boot up a Mario Party game and then we get very cutthroat and very mean to each other. It's a classic family tradition.
Mario Party in series history.
Tradition.
It's tradition.
And now, please take a look at this.
If we want to get along, we play Smash Brothers, ironically enough. That's Link's Awakening art style. Are we getting a new top-down Zelda, like a Link's Awakening sequel?
And he's got a little hood, like the Breath of the Wild. But he's got the classic.
Are we getting a Link's Awakening sequel?
I would blow my marbles if this is an entirely new game done in the same style.
This doesn't look like Oracle.
I was gonna say, it's...
This does not look like... What? I think it's a sequel! Wait a minute. No!
Oh no! Are we going to be playing a Zelda?
Are we playing a Zelda? Are we playing a Zelda?
Oh my gosh! I know they've been talking about this idea for a while. Oh my gosh!
We're playing a Zelda! We're playing a Zelda!
Oh my gosh, look at that!
That map looks like a Link to the Past map.
Oh.
Doesn't it kind of?
Yeah!
The mountains, the way they're positioned, yeah, and then, the Hyrule.
And like Hylia. Echoes of Wisdom. Oh my gosh, we're finally getting a... You can finally play as Zelda.
I'm Eiji Aonuma.
CDI don't count.
That's why I said we can finally play as Zelda.
I mean, there's Hyrule Warriors.
We just saw was the latest installment.
Like an actual
Legend of
Zelda. Echoes of Wisdom.
Oh my gosh, I have goosebumps.
Link has vanished. Now, it's up to Princess Zelda to...
Please show me gameplay. Please, Anuma. Please, Anuma.
You might be thinking, will Zelda fight with a sword then? Here, we wanted to create a new gameplay style that breaks conventions seen in past Legend of Zelda.
She's gonna use the magic. She's gonna... Could she transform into Sheik?
More. Please take a look.
Or some equivalent.
What's she gonna do?
Give it directly to us.
Stolen away.
Gameplay, yes!
Vast lands of Hyrule. Strange rifts have appeared and have taken many people.
Or do they go to the depths?
Now alone, Zelda meets the fairy Tri.
Oh, kind of looks like a Korok a little bit.
Called the Tri.
But a companion.
We have a party and we have a companion!
Across Hyrule.
Wait, she's got his...
She's got his hood, the one that he had.
She's got a staff. Are they like, is this Nintendo trying to do a remake of Wands of Gamelon? We're gonna show you how to do a proper Zelda game where you play as Zelda. She's got a wand! Come on! You can't tell me that wasn't an intentional reference.
You can create echoes of tables to get a leg up.
Oh my gosh. That's a hilarious magical copy ability.
Yeah.
You can create wooden boxes.
I can't wait to throw a literal chair at Ganon.
And unusual things like...
Give him the chair! Wham!
Separately or together is entirely...
Or should you copy water and swim up it?
Learn and create echoes of things you find while exploring Hyrule.
So this is straight up, like, very puzzly of a game.
Yes. Oh, so it's gonna have a lot of that freeform stuff that, like,
Even
Tears of the Kingdom did.
Different. you could pick up and throw a rock echo, for example. That's not all of them. You can also create echoes of monsters.
Zelda's the Pokemon trainer now.
Monsters have different abilities, so choose the one you want.
Oh, you can copy those annoying spinning blade things.
Wisdom is key, after all.
Oh,
that's
my goodness.
So cool!
This looks like it's going to be a really fun game. It's not just that we're getting a new top-down Zelda. You're playing as Zelda.
In a Hyrule without Link.
Well, this is exactly what I would have wanted, because Zelda is very different. So they have the great Deku tree.
I saw also the little the Deku, like from Ocarina of Time.
I hope you enjoyed this demonstration.
You know, like the little merchant guys that always pop up.
Oh yeah,
I saw one of those.
There are a lot.
Well, yeah, and like the guard designs also look straight out of Ocarina of Time too. So it's like there's a lot of
record puzzles and battle enemies will
change. Oh my gosh, this might be my favorite announcement right now. Oh my god, you read it!
Legend of Zelda.
Look at that art!
Launches September 26th.
I wonder if it's a sequel to Link's Awakening though.
Yeah.
Oh! I don't need it, but I want it. But I don't need it, but I want it. But I don't need it, but I want it!
So what was it? People were like, oh, they're totally abandoning all classic Zelda. Like, no, it's like...
Well, they said they still want freedom, and that's what Anuma said going forward. He still wants freedom in his games. But, like, freedom doesn't necessarily mean open world.
Yeah.
Also, there was a lot of, like, fun stuff in Link's Awakening.
Yeah. They were probably like, we still have this engine. We can do stuff with this.
Yeah. Oh, shoot. Do I have a mute button? Because there's a Just Dance. Maybe I'll just... Ooh, goodbye. Hey,
this is always the most annoying part when I'm making the videos, because these parts always get claimed with copyright bots, because this is all just licensed music and they just play it. They have no shame. They don't consider us YouTubers, us little guys.
I'm sure your music is fantastic and wonderful.
Yeah, it's not about the quality of the music. It's just the fact that this music is all copyrighted. I'd probably end up having to mute the section anyway.
Well, I muted it for you.
Yes.
So that way,
thank you.
So that way you don't have to deal with it. There's no sound. It's only the image.
And I don't have to fix it in post.
Yeah, no fixing in post. I fix it in current. Yay!
Yeah.
We have the technology.
Yeah. Work smarter, not harder.
A new Lego adventure.
Oh,
yeah.
This looks cute.
This is so funny to me because this is a Sony produced game and they're putting it on the Switch.
Well, I mean, I think it's going multiplat, this Lego one. But this game actually looks really cute.
It's also on Steam, but the fact that it's on the Switch at all is just hilarious to me.
I mean, it's a Lego game, so it actually would fit really quite well on the Switch.
Well, yeah, it will.
This looks so cute, though. I've played the first two Horizon games.
Do you think they're like, hey guys, can you put Aloy in Smash now?
Well, that's actually not, like, the quote, like, as everybody's, like, quoted at every single stupid outlet ever. It's really more of they asked, hey, so if Aloy ever came to Smash, would you want it? They were like, oh yeah, that'd be cool. And then every single media outlet are like, oh, asked if Aloy would Smash, they'd be totally open to it. Every single media outlet, copy-paste.
Player, local or online.
It's like,
go
co-op. Okay, you know what would be a real gaming headline is if somebody asked them if you want their character in Smash and they said no. That would be the real headline, because what dev would say no? Stray.
Oh, Stray. That was another PlayStation exclusive.
And no, it was on Steam as well.
Yeah, it did come to Steam, but that's funny.
No, little kitty. Long live the king!
Experience a decaying cyber city through the eyes of a cat separated from their family. And
finally, we got two awesome games on the Switch.
Yeah.
We got Stray and Little Kitty Big City. Everybody needs more cat simulator in their life.
Yeah.
Climb to the highest heights. Create new paths.
Move over, Assassin's Creed. The only parkour I want to do is as a cat.
Yeah.
Tight spaces. Think like a cat to make your way through the city.
Poor Clark. Purrcore.
Careful,
though. Yeah.
Not everyone is excited to have you slinking around.
They must be a dog person.
Hostile creatures ready to swarm.
First of all, dogs are wonderful.
To venture into more areas in an unfamiliar world. And make
cats
your
are very
way
cute
back
too.
To safety.
Can't we all just get along?
Stray finds its way onto Nintendo Switch.
That's cool.
Kitty! That's a funny announcement. I never would have predicted that. Oh, yeah!
Hobbits?
Yeah,
oh, yeah, the Hobbit
yeah,
game.
The Hobbit, the Animal Crossing Hobbit game.
Like a hobbit the rings. Now, a leisurely existence nestled away in
but, like, a little chill Animal Crossing game is a perfect game to center around hobbits.
Oh, absolutely. Like, that's the perfect game. And also, like, you can create your own little hobbits.
Yeah.
As a newcomer to the little haven of Bywater. You'll befriend your
neighbors. I actually kind
of
want this. This seems like it'll be a fun little cozy
and
game.
And even share a meal. Or three. Explore.
Yeah, more than three. Don't you know that there are seven meals a day?
Way to build a hobbit community.
They don't even know about second breakfast.
With your homemade dishes.
Do you think he knows what lemon is?
You can trade with your neighbors for unique decorations or special ingredients to make them tastier meals.
Okay, yeah, this... Oh, Gandalf!
Faces await your arrival when...
This is straight up just Animal Crossing,
yeah.
but with hobbits.
But that's cool, because that's the whole thing about hobbits, is they're just chill.
Yeah, they just chill, and they just want to look.
Oh!
Oh!
Two Ace Attorney
staff...
The secret was previously unreleased outside of Japan.
What?
...as one collection.
Oh.
Prosecutor.
No way!
Take the case out of the courtroom and investigate.
Oh my gosh!
Gather information by interviewing people and inspecting evidence.
Oh my god, look at the sprites though! Especially like walking around! They're all clean and look cute and anime-y!
The original series character designer. Or
oh my gosh!
Take a break from your investigation to explore the galaxy.
Francisca, she finally returns! Sure, it's in a clutch of Agnes, sir!
And more. Past and present collide as you uncover the truth.
Oh my goodness, this is so awesome!
Oh no, I don't know how I'm gonna handle the names they chose.
Investigations collection.
Oh.
They called Raymond Shields Fender. I was like, oh no.
Later today on Nintendo eShop.
We'll see. We'll see. It's just a problem whenever you're gotten used to something for several years, but oh, I'm still so hype! You do realize what this means, though?
Yeah.
Other than Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, pretty much all Ace Attorney games are now on one system.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. So this looks like...
Danganronpa.
Yeah, but I don't...
It's Spike Chunsoft, but like...
Yeah, it's the same... It's done in the same, it looks like it's done in the same engine as the Rain Code, Master Detective Rain Code.
Devastating attack by unknown assailants, Takumi Sumino's life gets turned upside down. A mysterious school mascot suddenly appears.
School mascot.
While Takumi manages to get out of harm's way, he's then forced to enroll at the Last Defense Academy, along with 15 other students. Their mission is to defend the school from hostile student enemies for 100 days.
Huh.
An academy shrouded in secrecy. And the unavoidable loss of allies.
I kind of dig that they're like wanting to branch out and not just do Danganronpa.
Yeah.
Extreme and despair and return to his
I still need to play Raincode. It's on my backlog.
Yeah, I got it. I just haven't played it yet. I have so many games.
Launching on Nintendo Switch.
I'm curious about this one.
Huh.
Embark on a saga.
Oh yeah.
Oh,
saga.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was
Saga.
Saga.
A full remake of Romancing Saga 2 is marching on to Nintendo Switch.
Nice.
Because I remember...
The Empire
was this
of the
sort of...
...across multiple generations while challenging the legendary...
Because I remember they mentioned Saga previously at another Nintendo Direct, but I wonder if that was a different...
They said Romancing Saga 2.
Yeah, but I wonder if this is like, is this...
...to learn skills... ...and formations to enhance abilities.
Looking up quickly.
Yeah, yeah.
Romancing Saga.
...into timeline battles where the action order is key.
Because I'm wondering...
Yeah, because the original game was Super Famicom.
Yeah, Super Famicom. Because that was a game I was interested in last time I saw one at Nintendo Direct.
And And in which order will you fight the seven heroes? Every decision you make will dramatically alter the course.
You're looking at worse than Switch.
Yeah.
Safeguard your empire's future and protect your legacy from peril. Otherwise, the vengeful seven heroes may emerge victorious. Romancing Saga 2.
Either way, whenever it was announced to that one last Nintendo Direct, I was like, I'm kind of curious about this franchise. I actually never played any of those games.
Yeah.
We hope you're excited to experience the full remake of Romancing Saga 2.
Yeah, I'm really curious about it.
That's almost everything.
One more thing. Metroid Prime 4. Let me cope.
Four or more Metroid Prime 2 and 3, please.
Yeah. Galactic Federation!
Wait a minute.
That looks like Metroid. Is it Metroid Prime 2 remaster?
Wait a minute! Hold on, Nintendo! Wait a minute, Nintendo! Hold on! Whoa!
Oh.
I've got a lot of goosebumps right now!
Is this Metroid Prime 4?
I don't think this is 2 or 3. I don't recognize this. No. No, 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 no.
Oh.
Hold on, Nintendo. You can't do this to my heart right now. It's racing. I think it's 4. Hold on.
It's been 7 years.
Hold on. And don't you tease it being like, actually, this is Metroid Prime.
Oh, is that Silas? Oh. It's Silas! He was from the teaser at the end of Metroid Prime 3. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! It's
finally
here! It's finally here!
It's alive!
Oh my gosh, we got Metroid Dread. We're getting Metroid Prime 4.
You need to bring 2 and 3 also on the Switch.
Well, I bet they're going to be like, oh, also we're launching Metroid Prime 2 and 3 remastered on this.
Oh!
Oh, 20 years. So I guarantee it's going to be a cross-generational game. There's going to be a Switch and a Switch successor
that
version.
That is a first look at Metroid Prime 4 Beyond.
My heart's still like, thump, 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 thump.
We are finally able to share more information about this title.
It's here! The memes can rest! There is news!
Looking forward to Samus Aran's new adventure.
Holy cow!
Okay, that's all for today's news.
I feel dizzy. Oh my god.
Thanks for watching.
What a way to end it! Okay, well, if it's coming out in 2025,
okay, I need a drink.
We still have time for them to release Metroid Prime 2.
Oh, it's about to play another trailer, sorry. Hang on, back. Okay.
Oh my gosh, I am legitimately...
I need more water. My throat's not dry.
Oh my gosh, I'm clipping this.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Oh.
Oh my gosh, that was such a good direct!
That's a fantastic direct!
So many good games! We have an actual playable Zelda game, but done in the Awakening
and
engine.
The Mario and Luigi.
The investigation games coming to
the
remastered.
The whole collection! And then Perfect Dark coming in Nintendo Switch Online, a new Mario Party.
Oh, the Dragon Quest 1, 2, and 3.
Donkey Kong!
Yeah, he's back.
Donkey Kong is back!
He's finally back! Now he's ready to kick some tail.
Oh my goodness. And then a lot of other great little titles in between here and there that look really cool.
Yeah, people are like, well, what do they have? They haven't said anything. Yeah, they haven't said anything because they've been holding on. We know they've been waiting for like a year
I'm
on
so
some of these.
I'm so glad nothing other than the date got leaked.
Oh my gosh. This is one of the best Nintendo Directs. Okay, there's a few little stuff, little Just Dance, whatever, but, like, consistently major stuff.
yeah, or like, sure, there was a lot of ports and things like that too, but it was like, oh, here's a beloved game like Stray, here you go.
Yeah, and the Dragon Quest 1, 2, and 3, 2D HD collection.
Like, everybody was, I remember everybody was guessing, like, because I was watching a lot of YouTuber predictions the other day, and everybody was speculating Dragon Quest 3 remake, HD 2D, that's what they were all saying. Nobody said that there would be one and two. Oh, that was like, that was a curveball I wasn't expecting. As soon as I thought, I was like, oh, everybody predicted this. And it was like, nobody predicted that.
Oh, but I am like super hyped. The Zelda, it's like, they recognize people want a playable Zelda.
But she's not going to play like Link, and she's got a little sidekick.
Yeah. It's like we get a new top-down game. Done in the Awakening engine, but...
And it's so cute, and it looks so good.
Yeah, but done with, like, the map of more or less A Link to the Past.
At least from what it looked like, it reminded me of Link to the Past, which makes sense, because if this does take place after Link's Awakening takes place after A Link to the Past.
Right, because he was out on his adventure, and then he came back.
So, that would make a lot of sense if this is a sequel to that game.
Yeah.
Especially because if Zelda didn't appear at all in Link's Awakening... She's mentioned.
Yeah.
But, oh man. Oh man. Holy cow. Oh,
man, the views on the Legend of Zelda trailer, 1.2 million.
I believe that. I believe that. Holy cow.
Oh,
whew.
Oh my and gosh. We finally got a view of Metroid Prime 4.
Metroid Prime 4.
I know, when it looked at it, I'm like, is this one of the remasters? Did they change Samus's ship design? But then I noticed that the
background, I was like, I don't remember any
of
that.
And like, she's got the Metroid Prime, like, the shoulder things, but they're much smaller and slimmer.
Yeah, I was just like, I'm like, I don't remember this in 2 or 3.
No. and then at the end, when I saw it, I
don't remember, and, I don't remember this.
And then at the end, I think it was Silex showed up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, because that was always the tease at the end of 3, where Silex is shipped from, that we saw from Hunters.
Yes.
He's like, follow Samus. You're like, oh my gosh, what's he gonna do? And then nothing since 2009. It's been a time.
It's been a minute.
It's been 15 years. It's gonna be 16 years when it comes out. 15 years since we last got an actual new Metroid Prime game. Spinoffs don't count.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, that was peak.
Thank you for watching.
That was amazing.
Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for being here. Thank you. I love video games. Bye.
Bye.